Fear. Pervasive, mind-numbing fear that gives a grown man all the backbone of a spasmodic jellyfish. That's our subject today, ladies and gentlemen. What is fear? Where in our psyches is it generated? Filmmakers utilize various elements for stimulating fear, for instilling it, anticipation, partial knowledge, a sense of helplessness, always one of my favorites. We'll study these and many other techniques that are used to excite terror.
What the hell is he yakking about? Fear this, fear that. It's all bullshit. Nothing is uncontrollable. Did I just say something out loud?
Mr. Craven, you have something to add.
Shit.
You just offered that nothing is uncontrollable.
Well, yeah. I mean, okay, when I was young and I saw something like Predator, I mean, I was really scared, right? So, I mean, in fact, I was so scared that if I ever had to walk down the street in the dark, I kept looking over my shoulder to make sure that I wasn't being followed, but yeah, I was 9 then?
9. That is rather a tender age for enjoying Predator.
Yeah, but that's kind of my point. You see, movies aren't scary for me anymore since I learned to logically comprehend that they're just that. They're just movies. So I think it's simply up to you and how you let the movie affect you.
So you're suggesting then, Craven, that there's a personal relationship between a given member of an audience and a horror film, that some of us bring, how shall we say, a special susceptibility to the genre, that inherent insecurity can galvanize the response. Interesting. No, really, Mr. Craven. Very interesting.
What a stupid kid. People following me. I can almost remember how I used to run up to the front of the building, open the door quickly, and shut it behind me. Used to jump on the elevator button, hoping that it's right there. And when it wasn't, ran up the stairs as fast as I could and locked the door to our apartment and slammed it behind me with terror. Freaking moron. Damn, it's never this quiet here. What the hell was that? Deja vu. I am still the same idiot kid. Still hate this walk, especially when I have $200 in my wallet. I'd be in a world of shit if somebody robs me now. Nice going, jackass. You had to open your big mouth. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. What if he robs me? He just wants to ask a question. Shit, fuck that. I'm walking. Thank you.
This is not happening. This is... just a freaking dream.
Oh, this is not a dream. This is not a fucking dream.
What was that? Who the fuck was that?
The self-fulfilling prophecy of endless possibility.
Trying to get my rap thing together.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
What you doing about it? You trying to make some money?
I mean, what you talking about?
Just a little something small. Some nice weed.
Man, but you know they say this shit will get you killed though.
Look, man. Let me tell you something. When you making money like this in a few hours, you can't worry about stuff like that. You can't.
That's how you doing it?
Just like that. I wouldn't worry about it.
How you protecting yourself, though?
You know me. You know I say strap, man. Matter of fact, it's a nice little gift for you. Handle your business if anybody steps to you wrong.
But I ain't trying to catch no murder charge.
Look, man, you want to be a rapper, right?
Yeah.
Then what's the hesitation? You can pay for your studio time. You can get your mixtapes put out there. Man, it's self-made right there. We make this money from the weed, and then you do everything you gotta do to go out there and make your music. Simple as that.
You're right, man.
You think I wasn't when I was?
I'm down.
Let's get this money then.
Let's do it.
Look, first things first though. What we need to do is we need to do.
Electroconvulsive Therapy, Part 1.
Go get, go get, go get, do the crap with me. Oh, go get, go get, go get, do the steak with me. Oh, go get, go get, go get, do the walk with me. Go get, go get, go ahead, gang.
First things first, aftermath, the chronic is back. This is Endo, produced by Timbo. Game over. Nah, the NWA chain choking. Burning rubber inside the Range Rover. Chain smoking. Purple haze. This ain't another one of those. This the rebirth for Dre. The rebirth for LA. The rebirth for hip hop. Another memorial for Machiavelli and Big Pop. Hold up, Tim, stop. I said this another memorial for Machiavelli and Big Pop. Young homie got shit locked, public enemy number one, Flavor Flav with a wristwatch. All black G units, all black Impala. I'm a schizo, we with him to 6-4. 50 Cent, no, I'm confident, most wanted when I'm riding.
Girl,
with Timbo.
Got a big back, let me bang that. Show me where your friends at, we can flip that. Let me put you on the game.
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 I'll show you where the blood's at, where the grip's at. Show you where they flip crack, where they get check. Let me put you on the game.
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 I ain't got the West on my shoulder, got the West in the backseat of the Rover. Riding on dubs, nigga, I'm West coasting. The next hover from the home of the best Doja, making on that racket. I got the US open. Stun on me, I'll leave you with your chest open. Vest broken, hopping the low low with the tech smoking. I done paid my dues, and WA is back. This is front page news. I got Dre in the back, riding on 22s. Bitches screaming, let me ride. It must be the shoes. Red and black G6s, red dot on the clock. I'm going 3 times platinum, dog. How do I stop?
Girl, if you got a big back, let me bang that. Show me where your friends at, we can flip that. Let me put you on the game.
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 I'll show you where the blood's at, where the grip's at. Show you where they flip crack, where they get check. Let me put you on the game.
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 My unit.
it is gorilla. Fuck with my life familiar, I will kill ya. I know that boy not familiar, but you got to feel him if the doctor sealed him.
It's Compton in the house.
Without a doubt, I'm the rapper with clout other niggas yap about. You know the one that introduced New York to the beach cruiser. Got them putting red and blue strings in they G-units. Get groupy love, tell them to keep moving. If I got a problem with a bitch, I let Eve do it. Unless she got on the Perla and I can see through it. I don't just let her ride, I give her the keys to it. Me and my bitch lay back in the coupe. I'm moving in the neighborhood, I ain't passing through. I would have been here after Snoop, but I slowed down to show Timberland how to iron a khaki
girl,
suit.
If you got a big back, let me bang that. Show me where your friends at, we can flip that. Let me put you on the game. Show you where the blood's at, where the grip's at. Show you where they flip crack, where they bitch at. Let me put you on the game.
Let me put you on the game.
Let me put you on the game.
Let me put you on the game. Return.
Yo, you know what this is?
Oh yeah, it's a classic.
Yeah, this is Body Rock by the Treacherous Three featuring Kool Moe Dee, LA Sunshine, Special K, and DJ...
Come on now, Easy Lee. Enjoy Records 1980. You know that's the first rap album ever to use guitar?
Yeah, and since you know so much, can you tell me why you have it marked $25 when it's going for $50 on eBay?
Well, 25 is good enough. Now I'm never gonna mess with that eBay stuff. Who's got time for all that bidding?
Yeah, it's not like you're on a computer all day, is it?
I'm trying to mix beats and make CDs, Jay. Not negotiating with some record geeks. It's all about the people, you know? I find out what they want, and I sell it for a fair price.
Yeah, well, I'm all about the business. And in the business, you make money.
Yeah, I know. And did you like those t-shirts?
Yeah, I got them.
Cool.
How much is this one?
Every day.
Yes!
For money on your Mount Vernon.
Oh my goodness, I used to love them when I was little.
Yeah, me too. Seem like a big fan.
Yes.
It's $5.
Sold. Thanks. There you go.
Okay.
So, how much does it pay?
You looking for a job?
Mm-hmm. I saw the sign.
It's $8 an hour.
Okay, that's like minimum wage.
That's all we could afford right now. It's a low-stress job, and if you love music, it's a good place.
Well, I'm only looking for something part-time anyway. I go to school.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What are you studying?
Culinary arts. I want to be a chef.
Nice. What's your name?
Oh, I'm Daphne.
Daphne.
Mm-hmm. You must be Akira.
Yeah.
It was on the sign, too.
Do you have any work experience?
Yeah. Worked in retail before. Yeah. Oh, and one of those photo places in the mall.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, huh. Do you want to start tomorrow?
Works for me.
Okay. Yeah, just show up by noon and I'll get you set up.
Cool.
Sorry.
Thanks. I'll see you tomorrow then.
Okay. Nice meeting you.
You too.
All right, I got a good one. Rakim versus Karis won.
What?
Who do you think's gonna win?
It's not even a question. Karis won. Come on now.
What?
Please.
Rakim's like the greatest of all time.
Oh my God, is this you? Please don't tell me this is you.
Yeah, that was, it was before I came to America.
Oh my, JWA, Japs with Attitude. No way.
Well, I haven't seen this in a while. Oh, we put out one record on their independent label.
Can I listen?
Yeah, but you know,
I've got to hear this.
You know the whole thing's in Japanese, right?
Yeah, that's all right. Music is universal. Okay.
That's a long time ago.
Okay.
Oh, man, I remember this.
I'm feeling it.
Yeah?
All right, let me think. I'm chilling here with the Japanese Jay-Z. He got a flow like a corn-fed MC. I kind of like him. His style's kind of fly. Imagine how you be with a little chocolate on your right side. Yeah, I think I add a little flavor to it. Mix it up, add a beat, then we chopped and screwed it. Turn it up, flip the record to the B-side. Take a step back, have a moment, let the beat ride.
Woo! That was awesome.
Thanks.
I didn't know you rapped.
Well, I don't, you know, just for fun. That's all. So wait. Forget about me. You have to tell me what brought you to America.
Well, I mean, in Japan, it's like if someone's into punk, they dye their hair pink and they go to the club. But it's like it's more of a fashion statement. You know, Monday comes around, they got to wash out the dye, put on a suit, and go to work. But I feel like in America, you know, if you are a rapper, a musician, or even a comedian, you know, I mean, that's your life. You're doing it full time.
Yeah, as long as you don't mind living with your parents all your life.
I hear you could work and still dream, you know? It's not like that in Japan.
Kumi-chan, すごい仕事してるのね. 今度はいつアメリカに行くの?
多分来週だと思います.
キャッチ入ったみたい. ちょっと待ってくれる?
はい、もちろんです。
母さん、俺。あなたからでもらって嬉しいわ。アメリカはどう？順調だよ。そっちはどう？私たちは元気よ。天気がすごくいいのよ。
うん。父さんは？あなたのこと心配してるわ。あなたがいつ帰ってくるのか知りたがってた。まだわかんないと言っといて。あなたの婚約者の久美ちゃんと今つながってるの。
え、母さん、俺たちただの友達だよ。はいはい、わかりました。母さん、こんなこと頼みたくないけど、ちょっとお金がいるんだ。今度はいくら？うん、5万円くらい。明日銀行に行ってくるわ。ありがとう、母さん。組も、よろしく言っといて。うん、わかったわ。うん、じゃあまた。組ちゃん？はい、まだここにいますよ、おばさん。アキラだったわ。
あなたによろしく言ってた。私、アキラのこと心配なの。心配しないでください。私が彼のことちゃんと見てきますから。それじゃあまた連絡しますね、おばさん。
Hey, so I'm about to close up. Are you getting picked up?
I don't know. I guess I'll just take the bus.
The bus? It's pretty late. Where do you live?
Limerick Park.
I can drive you. Come on. You all right? You hungry?
Starving.
Okay. Come on. I know a good place.
Can I get you something to drink?
Yeah, green tea, please.
How about you? Biru ga onegashimasu.
Biru to-chan. Shousho omachikasai.
Arigato. You speak Japanese? You didn't tell me that.
You didn't ask.
Wow, machite. Doku no ni mo naratta no?
Wait, slow down. I only know a few words. My major is Asian cooking. I love Japanese food, yakisoba, ramen, even natto.
Shinjirenai na.
Sukke meyoka na.
Hey, why don't we go somewhere else? I know a really good ramen place in downtown. Come on.
Oh, okay.
Mizuki, add. Gladys, delete.
Man, stop checking out that MySpace, Jay.
What's you so happy about anyway?
Nothing.
What happened to you last night?
I had a date.
You're right. Woohoo.
Hey. Good morning, fellas.
Something.
Oh. Okay.
It's a cookbook. My grandmother gave it to me before I left for America.
It's all in Japanese.
It's okay. It's a lot of pictures.
Yeah.
I can help you translate the recipes.
Yeah, well, that would take a while.
Well, I got time.
Oh.
Japanese.
She said Japanese.
Japanese?
Yeah.
You mean Japanese and black, right?
No, Japanese. Girl.
He's cool people.
Yeah. あの子ベッドでもすごいんだろ。
うん。
I heard Asian men are small.
Me too. You must have got that same memo.
Well, I will say this. He's not Corey, but he is packing and he knows how to use it.
あのさ、どうなのよ。黒人の子って変な匂いしない？
そんなわけねえだろ最高だったよ春の小川の桜って感じ
I did hear all Asian guys have nice cars and clothes
Hey, but have him buy you some nice stuff
He doesn't have any money
No money Then what's the point?
Right
Hey
That's Corey
Girl, what is he driving?
What's up, ladies? Yo, Dev, why don't you come take a ride with me?
Girl,
don't let your boyfriend, your Japanese boyfriend down, okay. Bro.
Yo, Rakim is the greatest of all time, money.
No. Let me educate you real quick, man. Snoop Dogg.
Snoop?
Yes, Snoop.
Paid in full, 1986, ring any bells?
Oh, that's a classic. Tupac.
Man, Tupac wasn't even messing with Big, man. You ridiculous. I'm getting out of
here. Hey, he died 10 years ago. He's still making hits.
Kumi, what are you doing here?
Your mother gave me the address.
You came here. You're healthy.
It's been a long time. There was a layover at the last time, so I came here.
そうだの。
ここあなたの店？
うん。何通しも前からかな。
そうなんだ。
Hey. This is Kumi. She's visiting from Japan.
Hi.
This is Daphne. She's our new worker. What are you doing here? You're not working today.
Well, I came to have a word with you. In private.
Right now?
Yes.
Yeah, sure. Kumi, just wait.
Okay.
What's going on? Is everything
Look,
okay?
I can't do this.
Well, hello there.
Hello.
You must be a friend of Akira's.
Hi, we grew up together in Niigata.
So you and Akira are like boyfriend, girlfriend?
Something like that, yes.
I don't understand, I think we had a great time.
Akira, you are my boss.
Is that what you think of me as, your boss?
Look, I just don't think that you and I would ever really work.
Why? Why don't you think it'll work?
We're from two totally different worlds. I mean, come on, let's be serious. Look, I can't work here anymore either.
Daphne, wait! Why are you doing this? Kumi, gomenne. Kumi!待ってよ Kumi!
Damn, man! How'd you manage to piss off two fine girls at the same time?
Akira が
父さん
町の噂になってるぞ俺は目の色肌の色が違う半分外人の孫なんていらないぞタイガーウッズなんて真っ平だ
何のこと言ってるの
クミちゃんが黙っていてくれてると思っているのか
女の子を傷つけておいてお前は
父さん母さんになんと恥ずかしい思いをさせてくれたんだ
俺恥ずかしいことなんて何もしてないよ
とにかくだな父さんはこれ以上母さんに送金させないからな
父さん母さんに
援助してほしかったら早く帰ってください。
できないよ。母さんに迷惑かけてコメント言っといて。じゃあ切るよ。
もしもし、アキラ。
焼き餃子すみません
ありがとう
でもありがとうございました
じゃあまた
Can I come in?
Sure.
Nice place.
Thanks.
You look great.
Thanks. What are you doing here?
Well, I missed you. You hungry?
No, actually, I just ate.
Have a dessert.
Introduction of seduction, running wild inside the mind. The fine line is broken, innocence is lost in time. Keep on dancing, playing with fire. We're gonna get burned with all the desire. The seven sins have now been implanted. Prison is framed by entrapment. They're not real, they're only pretending.
Now also, doesn't say so. Time is 16:40 hours on Wednesday, February 7th, 2007. All statements contained here within are given an absence of counsel. In custody is Leonard Dussard, black male, 50 years old. Hello, Leonard.
Winky Poppy, I love you. Winky Poppy, I love you. Daddy's little girl.
Winky Poppy, I love you. Winky Poppy, I love you. Winky Poppy, I love you. Daddy's little girl.
They found the body. Right where he said. African-American female, they're guessing between 5 and 8 years old.
It's just a baby.
She's a Jane Doe. Face mutilated beyond recognition. He used acid to burn off the finger and palm prints. No dental.
Cause of death?
Preliminary says strangulation. Got some semen from her rectum. I'm sure it's his. How long you been at it?
Almost 3 hours. He's playing games with me.
This sicko lawyered up?
No. He's talking. Nothing about the case. If I didn't know any better, I think he was interrogating me.
Your wife called.
Look, Charlie,
I know these are always rough on you, especially today. Go on with your woman. Let me finish this.
I got it. Strange as this may sound, I need the distraction.
You sure?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going back in for round two.
All right.
Nicotine and caffeine, my favorites. So you're gonna be nice to me now? You know, I read somewhere where detectives have to use a variety of tactics to persuade their suspect to cooperate.
You're not a suspect, Leonard. You confess. That makes you a defendant now. We found the body.
Good. It's wonderful. Because you know, it'd be dark soon, and most small children are afraid of the dark. I wouldn't want her left out there alone.
You like children?
Actually, I'm quite away with them. Children are a gift from God.
You believe in God?
Oh, absolutely. Don't you?
He and I aren't on the greatest of terms.
Now that's interesting. Not on the greatest of terms. Let's talk about that.
Winky Poppy, I love you. Winky Poppy, I love you. Winky Poppy.
Soul, Detective Briggs.
Yeah, well, it's the workload. I spent a lot of hours here.
Cape Crusader. Heard the networks want to give the highly decorated homicide Dick his own television show, just like John Walsh.
Yeah, just doing the job.
We all got a job to do. Divine purpose. So while you are out there doing the job, didn't leave much time for the family, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Is that the little lady calling to check on her wayward hero?
No, you right now you're looking at capital murder. And they'll expedite all your appeals, and you'll be dead, Leonard, in less than 2 years. So if you have any conscience whatsoever, just tell me about the girl.
You don't care for me much, do you?
No, I don't care much for middle-aged deviants who get off by violating then murdering little children. No, I don't.
Who says I violate them first? I've been sodomized before. It ain't that bad once you learn how to relax your muscles.
I'm trying to provide closure for a grieving family.
It's pity you don't show as much concern for your own family. So consumed with the work, you can't even take a call from your wife.
You don't know a damn thing about my family. This is pointless. I hope you rot in hell.
There were others, Detective. God gives us gifts in the form of children. And if we don't nurture and cherish them, he takes them away. My job, my mission is to bring those children back to a father who will always love them and protect them. You know, after 2 years, I bet your wife still blames you.
What?
Oh, you never forget your first. Mine? Oh, she was so sweet and innocent. Oh, and she taught me this beautiful lullaby that her father used to sing to her. How did it go? Oh, how did it go? Winky. Poppy, I love you. Winky Poppy.
found the body.
Speedy don't show as much as that.
Got some semen from her rectum. He used acid to burn off her finger and palm.
Small children you can't make a dog feel white.
I'm guessing between 5 and 8 years old.
You believe in God?
Oh, absolutely. Don't you?
I love my baby. I love my baby.
No, you didn't. You didn't love her. She told me you was her hero. She told me she loved you more than Binky Bear. And you did not reciprocate. People like you don't love your children. You don't care. You don't protect them. If you did, she would be here now. And there would be no me. There would be no me. There would be no me.
Sunday kind of love, a love to last past Saturday night, and I'd like to know it's more than love at first sight, and I want a Sunday kind of love. On the square, can't seem to find somebody, someone to care, and I'm on a lonely road that leads to nowhere. I need a Sunday kind of love. Do my Sunday dreaming, oh yeah, and all my Sunday scheming. a certain kind of lover who will show me the way in my arms. Need someone, someone to enfold, to keep me warm when Mondays and Tuesdays grow cold. Love for all my life to have and to hold. Oh, and I want a Sunday kind of love. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't want a Monday, Tuesday, a Wednesday, a Thursday, Sunday, Sunday. I want a Sunday kind of love. Oh, yeah. Sunday, Sunday, Sunday kind of love.
Boyd. 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 Why are you still here? Boyd. Why are you still here?
Fuck you.
Aren't you supposed to be at work? Hey!
What?
I said, aren't you supposed to be at work?
I don't work Saturdays.
Boyd, flip Zorro on. Boyd. Who is it?
It's Damien.
Damien, come on in, man.
Hey, Henry, is that Boyd? Hey, Boyd, is that you?
Fuck you.
Good morning, Boyd.
Fuck you.
Are you paying rent? Oh,
shit. Damien, give me a pillow.
Excuse me, good sir.
It's 11 in the morning. You guys are ridiculous.
So, Damien, what's up?
Well, Mom, she ran out of cash, so she just gave you a check. But what are you doing this afternoon?
Actually, I was gonna donate plasma today.
Are you sure you can do that high?
Shut up, Damien.
No, I'm not kidding. Isn't that against policy? Well, when are you gonna do that then?
3 o'clock.
Do you need a ride?
No, Lucy's gonna give me a ride.
cool. Mom was wondering if you wanted to come home for dinner tonight.
I'm not feeling it today.
D'accord, mais elle fait un gratin de chou-fleur. Ce mec-là, il est débile. Quand il s'accroche, c'est vraiment la fin. Tu feras mieux de le tuer.
Chakra bleu, oui oui, peu peu. Give me my fucking pillow back.
I'm out, Henry.
Fuck this.
All right. I'm out. Dinner's at 6 if you change your mind.
Damien, hold up.
No.
What are you doing tonight?
I don't know. I was gonna go see a movie with Folsom.
There's a party at the Sober House. Folsom can come.
No, he really can't. His mom, she wouldn't let him. But sure, I'll come. Can you pick me up?
Boyd?
No.
Yeah, we'll pick you up. You'll be at Mom's, right?
Probably. Just give me a call.
Hey, tell her I said thanks, okay?
Yeah, she says you can freeze the casserole.
Damien is the biggest pee-hole faggot in the entire world. You want a cigarette?
Hey, it's cool that we're picking up Damien, right?
Fuck Damien. Yeah, he can come.
Hobo!
Don't try to play this off like I'm using you. You know, Lucy, fuck you. Thank you.
3. I'll be there in 10. Turn on Zora.
Sunshine. I love the skirt. You ready to go? Hey, I thought I told you to turn on Zora. Wow, you've never acted like this before.
What are you doing?
Let's go.
What about Zora? Whoa, man.
Jesus Christ, hold up, man. Hold up. What's your problem? You're all stressed out. We've got 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Heat up Zora.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Your hair looks stupid.
How's the clinic?
Didn't go.
Why?
I think Lucy's breaking up with me.
Fuck Lucy.
Oh, come on, man. Henry! I swear to fucking God.
So, when's the last time you've seen your mom?
I see her all the time.
Well, yeah, we come to pick up Damien all the time, but when's the last time you've actually seen her?
Why are you so concerned?
I don't know, I just don't know what you've got against your mom.
She's my mother, what would I have against her?
I don't know, she seems like a very nice lady, and you aren't exactly the cuddliest son.
I don't see you giving your mom tons of affection.
It's because my mom's a bitch.
She seems like a very nice lady.
You know, it wouldn't...
Just shut the fuck up.
Show her a little affection every now and then. Rub her back. Play with her balls. You know. Hairy balls. Lovely. Lovely hairy balls that just melt in your mouth. If my mom had hairy balls, what are you laughing for?
I didn't know you smoke.
Dope.
Well, then you shouldn't mind if I don't smoke with you.
Actually, I do mind.
Hey, do you have any weed?
Oh, Damien, Mr. Adventurous. Boy does. You wanna find him?
No way is that worth it. Hey, man, how are things with Lucy?
We're breaking up.
How does it make you feel? Guess it makes you feel pretty shitty, doesn't it?
I guess it does.
Hey man, you gonna be alright?
I already am.
1 o'clock. I think she likes you.
Fucking bitch is on to something, dude.
Hey, you guys have a cigarette I can smoke?
Sorry.
No?
Sorry.
Just give me your money.
Whose knife is that? Damien, whose knife is that?
I'm in the fucking throat, bitch! So give me your goddamn money! Good night, bitch. I didn't hear you.
Family first.
Murder for breakfast. Murder for lunch. Murder for dinner. Murder for brunch. Murder for breakfast. Murder for lunch. Murder for dinner.
Are you still smoking? John, I can't believe you would smoke a goddamn cigarette.
I don't smoke that many.
I don't give a rat's ass how many you smoke.
Well, I'm trying to quit.
Hey, crying isn't good enough. Weren't you at your mother's funeral? Look, I'm not trying to tell you what to do or not do with your life. I just want to save in my life the one thing that still matters.
Come in.
John! What do you want me to do with this?
Oh, I got that.
Well, what do you think? Pretty cool, huh?
What the hell is that thing?
What? I thought it could, watch the house while we're gone.
Sure, Dad, whatever you say. Months. Don't worry about it. Why don't you wanted my ass out of here?
John. I love you.
Hey! Nice cap, dude. What do we make a deal?
A deal?
Yeah. Give me a buck, and I'll tell you the secret to happiness.
What makes you think I'm not already happy, buddy? Okay, here, have this.
Thanks, man. Count the stars to 111 before you go to bed. You'll wake up in the morning with tremendous happiness.
Kidding, right? This is Los Angeles. We lucky if I can count more than 10 stars.
When you wish upon a star, it doesn't matter who you are. La-da-dee-dee-dee.
Count 111 stars. What a stupid idea. One, two, three. What the hell is that? Beast close encounters of the third kind.
Help me! I'm in grave danger! Come on!
Slow to hell, please! Wait, just stop! Wait! Who are you?
Lorena Nojiwami's Toro Huirango.
What?
How about you?
My name's Tommy Valentine. You're supposed to be like an extraterrestrial or something?
I'm a princess from Ramuel, the third planet in the fifth solar system of the Pesteth galaxy. It's 70 billion light years away from here.
Okay. May I ask what you're doing on our planet from such a far distance?
It's a long story.
Okay, well, come with me. My house is nearby.
Take me there! Our galaxy is in enormous danger because there is another galaxy approaching. In a few years, a starburst will occur and the two galaxies crash into each other. Before this disaster happens, we must transport our galaxy into another space-time. Look. This is called the Zero Stone. If I can put it into the wormhole called the Rattan Energy Field, the space-time transport should be able to be completed. The Rattan energy field only emerges in our universe once every 25 million years.
Don't tell me that today is the day after 25 million years since the last time it emerged.
Not today, but tomorrow.
Is it going to be a difficult job to place the stone in the wormhole?
Not really. But there is one problem. An evil pirate makes his living off of selling the energy created by these starbursts. He has sent a space monster to hunt me down and assassinate me. Episode before.
It's true.
Do you guys see our TV programs on your planet?
Yes. Don't ask me why, but I've been addicted to your program since I was a kid.
What's your mother like?
She's a very intelligent woman and deeply respected by all of our people. I wanted to be just like her. But now she is sick, not in good health. Only women in my family can complete the time-space transport with the Zero Stone. I have to come here on her behalf. If I succeed, I will become the 111th Queen of Ramoel.
Your mother's gonna be fine, and you will be the next queen.
Thanks, but I'm afraid.
Don't be afraid. I'll help you. All I can do is just be with you.
Thank you, Tommy. By the way, is your life on this planet good?
I'm doing okay, I guess.
Do you have someone special to cheer you up?
Someone.
Special. You know. This is called the Spear of Milvatus. It is passed on in my family. It will give you power from your strong will.
Strong will.
Just take it. You will see.
Welcome, Tommy.
Who are you?
I am your ancestor. This is the place where the future meets the past. Our time stops at this very moment.
I'm not sure I know what you're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about. That's why you're here. I know the frustration of your daily life. I know that sometimes you think you're the unluckiest person on this planet. Am I right? You have to find a way to get through your limitation. I found mine when I was 17 years old. I became a knight. I fought in a war. I wanted to protect the people. I wanted to protect our family. And the woman I loved so much.
I'm not a brave man. I'm not sure if I can do it.
Just follow your heart. You will see. Now go back to your world, my offspring. Remember, the world can be changed by a person who never loses hope.
Magnificent.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Today more than ever. What's up with you?
Don't you remember that secret you told me? Guess I did count 111 stars, buddy. There you go.
You don't know what to expect when you get there. You're trained on how to manage situations that are stressful like this, but you really don't know what to expect of yourself until you actually get there. We got off the plane and at the Kuwaiti airport, and they immediately put us on buses and drove us like, I don't know how many miles out into the middle of nothing. I'll never forget. I mean, my hands were just shaking. I was so nervous.
Yeah, once we touched down, I felt really bad. Then I was ready to go home already. I actually had a couple tears drop. I ran to the bathroom for that, so none of the other guys would see that.
I remember right when they opened up the door of the airplane, it was just like a heat wave. So, you know, then it started sinking in, well, this is for real.
When we got into Kuwait, we had to wait for our tanks to get there. So we were there about 3 weeks or so. And once our tanks finally got there, they loaded us up on heads. And then came like a 30-hour push from Kuwait to Iraq. I mean, we did not stop but once for like 6 hours, maybe that much, to sleep overnight.
Once we crossed the border into Iraq, and there was Iraqis on the street waving and holding an American flag.
The head drivers told us don't let anybody get close to the trucks because there had been reports of Iraqis throwing little children out in front of vehicles during like ambushes and stuff like that throughout the country. I mean, they said, we're not stopping.
It just went from town to desert to town to desert, and then actually starting to see them blowing up Iraqi tanks. So I started pulling out my throwaway cameras and started taking pictures. My gunner, Sergeant Zimmerman, yelled out, well, here we go, boys. And I woke up, and there's a sign saying, Baghdad this way.
Well, we finally get where we're going, which was the Cross Sabers parade ground. And apparently that's where Saddam had all his military parades, where he would march his entire army in front of him and fire rounds from his 9mm and his 45 and all these different guns up into the air because he was insane. But we got there and downloaded our tanks, and the Hets took off, and we pretty much waited around there from about 10 in the morning until I think 9 o'clock at night when we finally found out where we were going. Nobody knew where we were going except for the guys who were guiding us around from 3rd ID. And they showed us where we were. We parked our tanks and just bedded down on the back deck of our tanks. Didn't care. It was like 11 o'clock by the time we got where we were going. I mean, we were just dog tired. I remember taking a baby wipe bath and just getting in my sleeping bag and passing out. The next morning we woke up, and it was probably about 7 or so in the morning, and the sun is just blaring down on you, and it's already like 95. And you wake up, and you're sitting in front of these two huge teardrop-looking things. I mean, they're blue, and they're massive. They had to at least been, you know, at least 900 feet tall.
After a couple days, we got in our own sector. It's called Sector 70, which was southeast of Baghdad.
Every platoon looked forward to the week of patrols because we got to go out in Sector 70. We got to go out and do rolling traffic control points. We got to go out and arrest people. We got to go out and, you know, do what we were trained to do, do what the Army called us to do.
My platoon, 1st Platoon, we were one of the first patrols out into the city.
Going through Sector 70 was always an adventure because you never knew what you were going to come across. And I mean, it was probably about 10 miles by 10 miles worth of road and villages and everything like that we had to go to. And they had different markets and all that kind of stuff.
Sector 70 was like the highlight of our positions, our job, because we got to leave base and actually go into a community and actually do something.
We helped rebuild a lot of schools. I think there were maybe 10 schools all in all that my company rebuilt while we were over there.
October 9th, 2003, So one of the scout patrols in Sadr City, which was known as Saddam City before the war, they were patrolling the city as the slums of Baghdad. It was about 5 miles by 5 miles square, and about 2 million people lived in that city. And they were ambushed. They called us out. They said, you know, we're heading into the city. They need the big guns. We started doing operations in Sadr City. A lot different because Sadr City was a lot more compact. The streets were narrow. The city itself was probably the grossest, nastiest thing I've ever seen in my life. They'd be throwing their garbage, their feces out into the streets. So there was one road on the far east side of the city called Route Silvers. It just smelled like a sewer, and every time we go out there, I just wanted to vomit. Even inside the tank, I could smell it. We started guarding what's called the DAC building, the District Advisory Council building. We hated doing it because we'd go out there for 12 hours and just sit while they had meetings going on within the building. We started guarding the building up on the rooftop with the new Iraqi army. We pretty much did that for months and months.
This is probably the last DAC. We've had some good times here, and we've probably had some really sick times here, but the most important thing is we're leaving this fucking place. Only 3 more days, Tufan's taking over, and we're glad they are. We're sick of this fucking place.
A lot of commotion on the radio, and I was listening in. It was soldiers screaming on the radio, and I heard the words KIA. There was an infantry platoon from 1st Cavalry Division who had been ambushed in Sadr City. Lieutenant Dean, he called out QRF to head into the city. So him and his soldiers had mounted up. They were our quick reaction force at that time.
Hopped in tanks real fast out of the camp. It was pretty intense because we knew that somebody was in danger, somebody had got ambushed. As soon as we got down to the main part of Sadr City, all these people with AK-47 shooting at us. I can hear the gunfire through the radio. Sergeant Dean said, he has a KIA.
Say again, over. And Sergeant Dean said, I have a KIA on my tank. And so they basically flat out said, who was it? And he's like, Mikey. And Mikey was nicknamed for Sergeant Mitchell.
He was a good guy. He was a mechanic. He was good at his job. He was a nice guy. He didn't deserve what he got. He was just rolling out to help. And an IP, right as he was getting ready to go down the turret, aimed an AK-47 at him and shot him right in the eye.
Lieutenant Fitzgerald just said, Albie, get us in the fucking city. Get us to the DAC. So we had pulled up on Route Delta. It reminded me of Black Hawk Down, and I think that was one of the first words I said, because the roads were on fire, they had barriers on the roads, there was shit on fire everywhere. I saw RPGs flying through the air, and something I've never seen before. There was a barrier about 75 meters in front of my tank. There was a couple of Iraqi insurgents trying to light it on fire. And then I remember watching the guy run out, and then all of a sudden just drop to the ground. Just hear the coaxial just drop. I was like, holy shit. I was the first person I ever seen get shot after 12 months in this country.
I walked out to smoke a cigarette and looked over at the Sadr City where all the fighting was, saw helicopters shooting, heard bullets left and right flying. You could hear it all, and I could hear the tank shooting, and just started shaking. I got so angry because I was stuck at the monument. Then I ended up having to go out with the first sergeant, helped him in a convoy, TC a Humvee, to go ID the body of the guy that was shot in the eye. Luckily, I didn't have to go in and actually do that. I didn't want to.
We went and tried to help out with Mike Mitchell's body. We went to take him to the medic station area. We were taking him out of the vehicle. He was covered, so I didn't see his actual body, but we saw the blood and the mess from that.